teachers. On both sides, there is kind of a pile, a graveyard of shoes. At a point in my presentation, if you could like pass one down each row, and they can kind of see what they actually feel like. So if we start maybe the first half at the back and then you guys take the front row, that would be helpful. The video cameras are on, so please don't walk in front of them. And then is there one of you that would mind pressing play when I get ready to do my performance? It's already on the song. So Corey, you will? Thank you. Mrs. Olson is gonna tell us a story today, because here in the next few months, I'm gonna bring in some other adults to share stories with you about their lives. And so before I do that, I wanted to make kind of like a practice one that I can show them that this is what we're looking for. So it's gonna be a bit of a story. It's gonna be a bit of show and tell. Raise your hand if you like show and tell. Raise your hand if you like stories.
Okay.
I didn't say to say yes or no. I just said if you did to raise your hand. Thank you. So first of all, I'm gonna dedicate this story to a lady named Laura Golfany. She is my dance mentor, and she's also my friend. And so I'm dedicating this to her, okay? So how many of you know that Mrs. Olson dances every week? Okay, so some, okay? Some know because they've been to the dance studio. Others just know because I've talked about it a little bit, okay? So when I was really little, I always wanted to do ballet, and I started, and I only danced for about 4 months, and all I remember is bringing my teddy bear to class. I don't remember any of the dance steps. And so then I moved over here, and I didn't know that there was even a dance studio in our area. I want you to think, I want you to guess, how old do you think Mrs. Olson was when she started doing ballet? Hold up your fingers. Okay, I was 13. Yep. I was actually almost 14. I wasn't even at the beginning of 13. Yeah, I was a teenager when I started ballet. Now, I have to confess, remember our electric slide? I did do some line dancing, and I did do some things that's called ballroom dancing, where you do like swing dance with a partner. I did do a little bit of that kind of dancing, but I didn't do ballet until I was a teenager, okay? So, and over the years, I've studied a lot of different kinds of dance. Like these would be jazz. This would be ballroom with a partner. This is like modern dance, okay? And these are my teaching shoes when I started teaching dance. And then these are my point shoes, okay? And then these are kind of the regular shoes you wear. They're called flats. You warm up in them, okay? So, my parents didn't really have a lot of money. And almost every month that I took ballet, I never knew if I was gonna be able to keep going because my parents could barely afford it. So they scrounged the money every month, and my mom drove me twice a week from Northport to Colville to take ballet classes. And because I started so older, it was only like 1 year before I got to go from these shoes to these shoes, which is kind of amazing. Normally you have to train for like 6 or 7 years before you get to go and on point. So it takes a lot of work, but I was kind of strong for my age. So, but it was kind of hard because I didn't remember everything I was taught quickly because I didn't start when I was young. And also, I'm not very flexible. I've only been able to do the splits for like 1 year of my life. I'm not flexible as a dancer. So in that way, dance is quite challenging for me. And after I graduated from high school, I had to decide what I was gonna do. And because I wasn't flexible, I made the choice not to go to college for dance. But I didn't stop dancing, okay? And so I also began teaching dance. I taught dance up by Northport, and then I taught dance for Laura Dauphiny in Colville. So then, after I was teaching dance, I got married, I had a baby, and I had to stop dance for like a year. I also had to stop when I was a teenager, too, for about a year and a half, because I was going to a different school. And so both times I stopped, I kind of had to start over again. And after I got married and I came back to dance, I only danced once a week, and you're not strong enough to go on point if you only dance once a week. You just can't stay strong enough. So I couldn't dance on point at that time. And then I went to work at Walmart for a year, all night long. I would work all night long. And at that point, my daughter had gotten older, and since she was older, I didn't mind. I went to the dance studio when I would get off work. I would work all night long, and then I would go to the dance studio for about an hour, and I got myself strong enough that I could go back on point again. And I was probably the strongest I've ever been. Like, back then, I was stronger than I am right now. Okay, I could do more things than I can. And so I kind of did an estimate of how many hours that I've spent dancing. Take a guess. How many hours do you think Mrs. Olson has spent dancing? If I started when I was a teenager.
500 years.
500 hours. Okay, any other guesses? 700. Okay. All right. I'll tell you. And this is just an estimate of just taking just ballet classes. I counted up about 1,482 hours, but that doesn't include the time I've taught, extra classes, performances. It doesn't include all the extra stuff. That's just class. Okay? So I'm going to kind of move this out of the way. And I'm going to kind of give you a little show and tell of what it's like to actually get ready on and wear point shoes. So if you guys want to actually grab a toe shoe and start passing it down the aisle, you can actually, they're right there, there's a graveyard of them. Then you can kind of see what they actually feel like. They're really hard. They're made out, most of them are made out of cardboard, glue, leather. Mine, because I got so strong, I actually couldn't really afford to buy them. They're like $60 a pair. And luckily I found this pair is made out of plastic, and so I don't have to buy it all the time, okay? That's the only way I can actually afford it, because if I had to buy $60 shoes every couple of months, I couldn't dance, okay? I gotta put a little tape on my toes so I don't get blisters. Okay. And then, so Mrs. Olson's going to continue her story while I'm putting these on. So 7 years ago, I had to quit dance again because I had another daughter. Her name's Julia. Some of you know her. And again, when she was not a baby, I went back to dance. But I started to have some injuries. My tendons and my feet started to bother me. And so for 4 years, I didn't put on a pair of toe shoes because I was afraid that I had hurt my feet too much. And then Mrs. Olson decided she was going to research it just a little bit more. And so I started to get rid of all my old shoes, and because I realized that I had really wide feet. And so wearing any narrow shoes or any heeled shoes really made my feet hurt worse. So after I got rid of all my shoes, and then I sent in drawings of my feet to the company that makes these shoes, and I made my own toe pads. This is a handmade toe pad so that I don't hurt my toes. I was able to go back on point last year when I started taking more classes again because Julia was older and both my girls were in dance. So now I've been dancing on point again for about another year and a half. Okay? So, but I still have to be careful, and I kind of made a promise to myself that if my feet really continue to bother me, that I won't dance on point anymore. But today, since right now I'm strong enough, I'm going to show you what it's like to dance on point. Okay? So you can see I have to tie these ribbons on. I had to tape my toes, put in a special pad I made myself so it doesn't hurt my toes. Okay, I'm going to take my microphone off right now because I can't dance with the microphone. And I got to get my feet wet because the floor is too slick, so I got to put water on my toe shoes here. Job For me, it was both. But don't give up on your dreams. And realize that when you're an adult, you do lots of different things, not just one thing. And it's okay to make mistakes. I just made a whole bunch of them in that dance. Did you notice?
No.